Welcome back, Batman fans. Today I'm really excited to bring to you an unboxing from the Dark Knight Rises Heroclix foil packs. Now you can get these at any of your Walgreens. I went to a bunch of the Walgreens around my house and my town, and only two of them were actually selling these boosters. One of them did not know the correct price and they were selling them for $2.99. But then there was another one that I found selling for $1.99. And I also saw someone on HC Realms say that they're going for like $1.99 as well. So just be on the lookout. They are being released. Now these supposedly are somewhat limited in what figures you can get. I'm not exactly sure. I already opened up a bunch here. 10 down here we have Arkham Asylum Escapees, Catwoman, Shadow Assassin, GCPD, Officer, and then Two-Face. The Two-Face is from the big set from like, you know, like 20, like 30 figures. I think it's number 9. Catwoman is from the Target exclusive. She's like 203. The Shadow Assassin is number 2 in the set, so he's also from the big set. The PD Officer here is number 5. And these Asylum people are 210, so they're also from like the Target exclusive one. So it's really, really weird. But we're gonna open them up, check them out, and see what we get, and then go through a little bit of the dials. So we're gonna quickly go through the package here. We have a Batman figure here. Don't know exactly which one it is, because there's a bunch of Batman figures in this set. We have the Bane, and then here in the corner is the Catwoman, which is Anne Hathaway. Very nice. And then here on the back is another thing. It's just foil pack, collectible, miniature, game piece. Just one figure, collect them all. It doesn't say, it might say down here, but I don't think it says anything major. Let's open up and let's see. I hear a lot of these boosters are a bunch of generics. So we have Mercenary. This is number 8. Underworld figure. This is what he looks like. Looks pretty cool. So this kind of rings true so far. As you see, I have 4 Arkham inmates, 2 Shadow Assassins, and 1 PD. So looks like a lot of these are going to be, you know, your generics and your grunt figures. So we'll see. But I did pull 2 Catwoman and 1 Two-Face. So there are figures in there. And like I said, there's a Batman picture and there's a Bane picture. So I expect them to be somewhat in this. So let's finish open these up. All right, this looks like it is gonna be Bruce Wayne, number, he's 80 points. It's an AE, this Mastermind figure. I'll go through the dials a little bit later, but yes. So we do get a Bruce Wayne. Obviously that's not a generic. Officer here, so that's a couple more. And we got our first Bane figure. Very awesome. Let's see which one this one is. I believe it's, let's see, 204. So here's the Bane. Very nice. Definitely the new look from the movie. Let's continue on with this. I'm pretty happy now. Looks like we have another Bruce Wayne. Oh, we got our first real Batman. Oh, yes. It's cool, cool, cool. I have been waiting for this set forever. 75 points, AE, the 80 figure one. So that's crazy. Let's look. This is 201. This is the figure 201. It's kind of hard to see here, but we will, like I said, we'll go look at him again. We have another Bane figure. So far, we have everything on the art. We have that Batman and the Bane, another Catwoman, and that's also 203. So it looks like I might have everything that might be in here. So it's interesting. Another Two-Face. That's a double. I'm gonna be able to trade a bunch of these figures with some friends. Another Mercenary. All of the figures look pretty cool, but their sculpts and their paint jobs are kind of a little lacking. It's not necessarily their nicest looking figures, but you do get a good representation of what they look like in the films. So that's pretty cool, but you know, it looks like they probably didn't spend the most money on making this set. It doesn't look the greatest, but it's still pretty cool. So we have the Shadow Assassin. This figure can be played on a rookie and experienced dial, so you can play him at two different dials, but he's 35 points and he has the new team ability Underworld. This character can carry another Underworld user during a move action, or two others if they both have a lower cost. Now he's 35 points, so it's going to be hard for him to be carrying two other people of lower points, but he could be carried because he's pretty low. Some other things I'd like to note, I mean, he's got a lot of different powers here, but stealthy, we have blades, super senses, they both have special powers. I'm not going to go over, but on both sides of the dial, they have special powers, combat reflexes, blades, poison. So a little bit of a bunch of close combat powers on either one of the dials. And then we have Catwoman. Pretty cool. She is Batman TA. It looks a little different, but it does the same thing. 65 points. She also has a special power, Cat Burglar. Catwoman can use Flurry, give Catwoman a free action when she is adjacent to a heavy or a light object and exchange that object for any other object on the map or held by another character. After doing so, roll a d6 on the result of a 1 or a 3, remove the exchange object from the game. So that's really cool, good way of getting objects out of the game. So that's really awesome. And looking at her dial, she has combat reflexes and perplex, leap, climb. So she's going to be really hard to deal with at close combat. Mercenary is going to be really one of Bane's little brute members. He's also Underworld, so he has that. He's 45 points. He also can be played on a rookie and uncommon dial, so that's really awesome. You can kind of one dial is a charger with toughness and flurry, and another one is flurry, quake, exploit weakness, and close combat expert. And they both have special powers on either one of those dials. I'm not going to go all through that. I want to make this video quick. You can go on HC Realms and you can read up on all the dials and the stats on them and, you know, get a better idea instead of watching the video. We have Bane here. He's brute monster soldier, 90 points, Underworld as well. He has a trait, bring the city down, give Bane a double power action when he occupies printed hindering terrain and place a special marker in the square he occupies, and that area is clear terrain until the end of the game. So basically he can knock down whole areas of elevated terrain and make them grounded or clear. So I think in the movie he has like a rocket launcher, and also there's a power here that says rocket launcher, which would give him range combat expert as if he had 8 range, which is a special attack power. And he also has special defense where he can possess mastermind and toughness. This power can't be countered. He also has perplex. So, you know, very cool figure, only 90 points, so he's not super powerhouse, but it'll be fun, and there's probably going to be another Bane in the big set as well. Alright, so let's wrap this up. Two-Face, 65 points. He is the Batman enemy TA, so that's really nice to get some new figures with that. Stealthy figure, Flurry. He's in Dom as well. He's got probability, outwit, and he has a special attack power, which is pretty cool. Once per turn, when Two-Face makes an attack and his attack total is 1 less than the target defense value, he may immediately make an attack against a different opposing character adjacent to the previous target, which I'm going to assume he doesn't need line of sight. But I don't know, just because it doesn't say anything with line of sight. So that's really, really awesome. And he also has prob, so that is very awesome. Very, very awesome for 65 points. And his attack starts off with a 10, but it's Batman enemy, so pair him up with someone with a higher attack, he can share that. So that's really nice. Bruce Wayne, 80 points. He is basically, it looks like it's a leap climber, Incapper, and Mastermind figure, so that's really interesting. And he actually AEs into a lower pointed figure, because the Bruce Wayne is 80 points, and the Batman right next to him, right in the center here, is 75 points. So that's really interesting. He also has Outwit. Let's get into that. Batman He has a trait, Batman's combat values can't be modified by other friendly characters. So, and he doesn't have perplex on him. So I'm thinking on outside the game, say if you had the gauntlet, which, you know, it's kind of weak because they're coming out with the Batman utility belt. Say if the Batman utility belt gives you bonuses, then because that's not a friendly, you know, another friendly character, that would be able to bonus his stats. But a friendly character can't bonus him up. He has a really nice power for movement, which reminds me of Out of the Shadows, but this is actually seems to be better on the run. Batman can use charge and leap climb. When he uses charge, he can use plasticity and he can use charge normally. Or he can be given a close combat action as a free action and then move. Now, this is pretty interesting because on that second part, it says close combat action and then move. Now, it doesn't necessarily say he can use plasticity when he for that second part. So that might you might have to roll breakaway, which would be kind of not as good as Out of the Shadows. But the first part's pretty nice because you can use charge and break away and then come back in. He doesn't have super strength, but it's pretty interesting, and I kind of like it. You can't hold him down. He's got combat reflexes, and he starts off with exploit weakness and a 12 attack. So this is going to be a nice, nice figure for 75 points. It's going to be very nasty. Then we have the PD officer. He also can be played at two different point costs. And he's PD at 40 points. And on his experience side I want to cover, he has this backup trait. When the GCPD officer is adjacent to another character with the police keyword, he can use perplex, but he can only target characters with the police keyword. So if you play a police team, or if you play him on another team, like a Gotham City, but someone else with police, he can have perplex for 40 points. It's gonna be pretty cool. I like that. And then our final figure that I got four of, Arkham Asylum Escapee. I guess it's pretty cool that I have four of them because, you know, there's a bunch of them. 45 points, Underworld, and some notable things. He's got Flurry, Stealthy, Willpower, Battle Fury, and Exploit Weakness. So thank you guys for watching my unboxing of the Dark Knight Rises little mini set here. It doesn't really come with a bunch of figures. It looks like it might be limited to these 9 figures, probably a couple more, but not too many more. Just randomly put some stuff together from Walgreens. But anyways, the main set should be out in like 2 weeks, and possibly Target figures will be coming out sooner than that. Take it easy and tell me what you guys think. All right, guys, see ya.